Today I will show you how to monitor Ethos by using Python, and also how to put the scripts in the HTML in Apache server, so you can put a cron job and monitor the rig, like how depends how often you want, maybe every 5 or 10 minutes. And then you can get email notifications if there is something not right with the cards or the rig or the total has a temperature. So this is the page I have. This is the kind of basic HTML5 page, and these are the values I'm monitoring. The available GPUs, I have 6, notifications for 4, no problem. But if this becomes 4 or less than 4, then I will get an email. I will show you how it works. So the same is for the total hash. Currently it's 171, notifications for 165. There is no problem at the moment. So everything, I'm using the maximum value for notification for everything except the average temperature. I'm using the minimum value, actually minimum value for everything except the average temperature, which currently is 57, notifications for 80. So I will show you in the script when it's asking you for temperature, you have to use the maximum value, not the minimum. And also there is the condition of the rig. At the moment is mining. This information are coming from the API, and if it's something else, no mining or stopped or anything that appears here, except mining, then I will get an email notification. So this is the basic homepage. But the API URL, I will show you how to get. So if you go to your Ethos page, there's an API here, you click the API and you get a URL plus a couple of information. So there are information for everything related to the rig, RAM, CPU, load and everything. But the values in the miner, which is at the bottom, I'm using Claymore, the values here for the miner are the ones I'm using and trust. Because this is what is reporting back to the pool. So to monitor the miner is very important. Of course, you can monitor other things if you want to. So this is the API information. Something new for AMD cards in the version 133, which I think currently is the latest one, version 133, yeah. The new one is the watts, or is it total watts, 829. So this is new, before it wasn't working, but this is another good value to monitor. So if it goes to 900 and above, probably you want to get a notification. And also I have a GitHub. So this is the GitHub Ethos monitoring. I will put the URL in the description page. So this is the URL. You can get from here the files, and also I created a readme file explaining the steps, which I will go through during this video. Okay, so let's see how it works. First step is you will need a server, probably Raspberry Pi or a server in the cloud. If you have any, you can also put these files in, which have Python 3, and also you will need an Apache server. And then what you need to do is you need to take all these rig files. All these files have basic information except the email, the rig API, and the values you want to monitor. So everything is pre-populated, as you see here. The only missing part is this gap here, which will generate automatically from the main script. So you just need to copy these rig files in the same folder with the rig monit. So for example, in this local server I have, I put all the rig files together and the rig monit. So this is very important to be in the same folder. And then you run the main script, Python rig monit. We run this. First question is as per step 3, which is your API and your email. So we're going to get the API URL, put it here, and your email. This is my email. If you want to send me, if you have any problem, let me know. You can use this email for any communication. So we enter the email. Now, step 4 is very important. Now you can see it's retrieving the data from the API URL, and that's the raw data from the API as per this one. It's exactly the same, but this one is modified by the plugin, but this one is just raw data, but it's the same exact information. And then step 5 is asking which settings you would like to monitor. Under each number you can see the values. This is the canon values which coming from the API. So let's say I want to monitor total hash number 2. I type number 2. Now we are in the step 6. Type number 2 and I'm getting just a notification. You're going to monitor total hash. That's fine. And which is the minimum value? Yeah. So minimum value I want for this is 165. Enter. And then the information now from the main script is already inside the monitoring script for the total hash, which is this one. So if I open this, we have the information here. So actually I already did once, so added twice, but you should see only these 5 lines as per step 7. So you should see the address, the email, the string which is the current value, the value I'm going to monitor, and the minimum value which I've chosen. So we have this information here. So maybe I would try another one. I think I didn't use, let's see, the old GPU script. You see this is empty, there's nothing here. So I'm going to monitor, what is there? Monitor API URL, email, alive GPUs number 3. Alive GPUs currently is 6. I want to get notification when it goes to 5. Okay. So if I open the script, alive GPU, you see the information is there. Before you saw 2, because if you run the script twice, it's just append and adding lines, it's not overwriting. So it's good to run it only once, but also you can edit this individual monitoring scripts by hand. So this script is quite similar, all the scripts are similar to each other. So there are some definition here, and also some kind of conversion to get the appropriate values in strings. And after we get the correct information, the number from the current number 6 from the API, I'm using if to compare it with a minimum value. So if the minimum value 5 is equal or less than the current value, then there's a problem and then we get an email. I'm using at the moment mail package from Linux, but you can use other mail packages, but I found this more easy and convenient. So I'm using this inside the as the body of the email, and then the email address, you have to modify this address based on what you need to which email you want to use, and this Ethos worker etc, this is the subject, and then at the bottom of the mail there are some prints. These four prints are the same as this one, so available rigs, total available GPUs, let's say this one. So it's the same information, current condition, notification, if there's a problem. So this information are going to the log which I'm using for the HTML5 page, and you can you can check it from anywhere. So just remember to change your email here, otherwise I'm going to get emails for everyone. Okay, so let's exit that. So now I monitor two things. One is the total hash and the other is the alive rigs. So let's see also the total hash. Rig total hash. So again we have the populated information on the top, some definition, conversion, UTF, and then there is the same if here. And at the end we have the prints. Now if I want to run this script, you can use cron jobs to run all these individual scripts. All these you can use, all the rig ones, you can use cron job. So if we go back to where we are in step 7, so we got the information in the rig scripts. Next one is to create a log folder and the log files. So you can create, for example, if you have home Python folder where you put all the rig scripts, then in the same path, home Python, you can create another folder logs, and you can put here, just create the files with these names, and then you have to create this cron job if you want to monitor. I'm monitoring every 30 minutes, but if you want to to change that, that's fine. So with this cron jobs is running this the script like I would do now. Python total hash. So I'm running the script, I'm getting this information, these four lines, and these four lines are going inside the log file. And the log file is the one I'm retrieving to get it to the HTML page. So of course this is up to you if you want to use the same method or if you want to use something different. But if you have the scripts inside the folder, you have to run a cron job and run these scripts every 5 minutes, 10 minutes, and then if something changes, you get an email. Because you get also email from the pool, but that probably is coming after an hour or more, maybe 2 hours. So at that time it will be too late if you get notification after 2 hours. But this one, if you put every 5 minutes, you get notification very often. There is no problem, you don't get an email, but you get email only if there is a problem. So after you put the cron jobs, then you can install you have to install actually the web server, Apache, And also you can install the mail and mail utils. So this is for the mail package I'm using, but you can use something else if you want. And also, when you have the log files in the home Python log folder, and you want to use the HTML page to check it, to check the information, then you have to use the rsync command again inside the cron job. You have to use the rsync command to sync your the logs with the same folder or the and stats folder inside the HTML, the Apache URL. So here it's just actually copying these log files to the Apache. So when the files are here, you can create a basic HTML5 page like this, and you just open the file with just with some information here, can write anything you want, and then you open the file and you get this page. But you can put anything you want as an HTML5 if you know about HTML5, then you can use anything you want here. So, but more important is you put the scripts in the folder home Python, and you have a cron job to run the scripts. And then, if there is a problem, you get an email. If there is no problem, you don't get an email. So now let's see. According to my total Python total hash, my hash is 171. I'm monitoring for 160. There is no problem, but I'm going to modify it so I can show you how it works. I'm going to use string final one. So I'm going to use 160. So I just force it to be to create a problem. So I'm monitoring for 160. String final one is also 160. I should get an email according to the if condition. Save it, run it. There you are. So what happened is when you run this command, where is it here? Because there is a problem, it's checking the SMTP for Gmail. So when you use your mail package, you have to configure it to use the SMTP you want to use. From the moment I'm using Gmail because it's open and free, it's connecting to Gmail. This is just information about certificate. And then it's doing a DNS check, SSL. Oh, no. Okay, and here it's connecting to SMTP, and it's doing the authentication. Accepted, and here it's adding the information data, and then after everything is okay, it quits. So all this is the SMTP connection. Close the connection here, and also I'm getting this. Current condition is 160. This is from the Python script. It's not from the SMTP. Notifications for 160. Is there a problem? Yes, there's a problem. So if we go here, total hash. This one will check it in about 30 minutes as per the cron job. But if I put 5 minutes, I should get it. Of course, I don't want to wait for 30 minutes. But I already got the notification here. So if I go to my email, okay, let's see. If I go to email, I got an email here. Ethos worker update. So this subject is coming from the mail, Ethos worker update, and then This is the email I'm using from Gmail, which I'm using only for monitoring. And then I have just a fixed message for the body. So this gives me the information I need to go and check what's going on with the total hash. So now I would just change it back. Now if I check again, there's no problem because it's 171. So then where we are, I show you how what's happening when you run the scripting on what if there is a problem. But if you put in a cron job, of course it's doing automatically. So that's all. You can use the same scripts, or you can modify them if you want to get notifications. So if you like this work and if you think it's important for you, you can also check my YouTube channel, it's at the end of the readme, and my Ethereum wallet if you want to donate something. So thank you for watching, and hopefully someone is going to use it to monitor his rig. So see you next time. Thank you.